Prior to the arrival of the sky-worshipping Hellenes, the original inhabitants of Greece worshipped the Earth Mother Gaia. As was traditional in the vast majority of cultures, the Earth was seen as a female figure, fertile and mysterious. This was reflected in the religious attitudes of these archaic Greeks. Women were priestesses, representatives of the goddess on Earth. This goes back further than history itself, shown by sculptures and cave paintings extending back to the Neolithic period. In these matriarchal societies, the female body was to be worshipped. The act of making love was itself a form of devotion, a holy act recreating the sowing of the fields from whom would spring forth life-giving crops, or that of Kronos' insemination of the Earth Mother. Eventually, cultures began worshipping the sky gods, be their name Zeus, Jehovah, Yahweh, Thor, or any such variant, and the worship of both the Earth and women faded. The new male divinities were creators rather than parents, and forced women into a very minor role, as bearers of children who would never carry their names. The female form became something to be claimed and used, rather than an altar on which men could sacrifice their masculinity. The shifting of power dynamics went across all facets of society, perhaps best exemplified by farming. The farmer became a tamer of the earth, rather than an individual working in tandem with her, reliant on her moods and shifting seasons. Sex had been suppressed by the authorities of the Western and Near Eastern worlds, and as much due to this as despite it, the female body had become a fetishized image. Fetishized is as far as can be from worship, and instead is a degrading separation from the norm. With this attitude, sex became something belonging to the male, something dirty and impure that women were not to enjoy. Sex had become sacrilege rather than sacred. Hosier, an Irish poet and singer-songwriter, is seemingly a throwback to the Chthonic days of lovemaking. He honours sex as a sacred ritual and describes the bearing of soul and physical intimacy to the partner as its own ceremony. Similar to ancient Greeks describing the Eleusia mysteries, the passionate act of coitus is one in which the individual fades and disappears into their partner. Hosier's most famous song, and the one that talks most clearly about this relationship with the female sexuality, is Take Me to Church. This song is a rejection of the patriarchal societal norms of Ireland. Rebelling against the strong Catholic roots of his homeland, Hosier offers the idea of the fluid, shifting, and metaphysical church in which bodies are the altar and the orgasm the crowning moment of the ceremony.
My church offers no absolutes. She tells me worship in the bedroom. The only heaven I'll be sent to is when I'm alone with you.
The woman as a nature goddess is best seen in Foreigner's God, a song in which he directly quotes the hypothesis I have offered about the ancient Earth Mother cult being replaced by the masculine sky-worshipping Indo-Europeans.
Since some liar broke the thunder, when the land was godless and free.
His work explores the idea of a man raised in a traditional Western fashion, being made aware of the holiness of the female figure and his instinct battling with his culture. The awareness of sexuality as a pure and positive thing has become so alien to Western society that to feel the combined feelings of both love and desire is an affront to society and a confusing feeling. This separation from nature is something that has reached such heights that to engage in any form of display of physical affection in nature, be it by a river, in a park, or in a field, is considered unusual rather than a form of devotion to the individual. As in nature, it is rare for animals to be monogamous. Hosier seems to continue this vein, the present worshipping, eliminating any sort of past.
I will not ask you where you came from. I will not ask, and neither should you.
The way women and sex are both elevated in the works of Hosier is not entirely unique. Jeff Buckley and Leonard Cohen had songs which were not dissimilar in terms of the attitude towards making love. However, their views on the women are not so clearly stated, and as such fall short of the standards set by the Irishman. Hozier's views are seemingly not too dissimilar to the matriarchal societies that many scholars postulate are now patriarchal and monotheist system come from. For the first time since perhaps Minoan Crete, the Bull Leapers, and Theseus of Athens, the idea of the holy mystery of womanhood has been brought back into collective consciousness.